The International Space Station, ISS, orbits at an altitude of 400 kilometers above the Earth, completing one orbit approximately every 90 minutes. 15 countries, including the United States, Russia, Europe, Canada, and Japan, are cooperating to build the ISS. It is the world's largest space experiment facility, with 6 astronauts currently on board. The Japanese experiment module Kibo was completed in July 2009, and Japanese astronauts are also scheduled to visit the ISS for long-term stays. Supplies such as food, water, clothes, and experiment devices are currently being transported mainly by Russia's resupply vessel, Progress, the European Space Agency, or ESA's ATV, and NASA's Space Shuttle from the United States. The Japanese H-2 transfer vehicle, HTV, which is being launched this time, will join this group and take on the new role of transporting supplies. The H-2 transfer vehicle, or HTV, comprises 4 sections, namely the cargo sections of the pressurized logistics carrier, an unpressurized logistics carrier, the avionics module equipped with navigational electronics, and the propulsion module for rendezvousing with the International Space Station, ISS. The cylindrical body is about 10 meters long, with a maximum diameter of 4.4 meters. Its size is similar to a sightseeing bus, with a capacity to transport approximately 6 tons of supplies to the ISS.
人工衛星の技術とかですね。あとはまあジェム衛星ね。希望のような技術、有人施設の技術。まあこの3つをその集大成しないとできないようなシステムなんで、まあそういう意味では非常にその中身の濃いですね、有意義なプロジェクトかなと今になったら思っていますね。はい。
The HTV will transport basic supplies such as drinking water, food and clothes, experiment devices and samples, as well as other supplies on a regular basis to the International Space Station, ISS. The total mass of the HTV, including the supplies it will carry, is approximately 16.5 tons, which was beyond the launch capacity of previously developed rockets in Japan. Therefore, the H-IIB launch vehicle was newly developed for the HTV. In Japan, large-scale launch vehicles with a greater launch capacity have been developed to launch larger satellites and space probes. The H-IIB launch vehicle, which was developed by improving the H-IIA launch vehicle, has the greatest launch capacity among Japanese rockets and can launch the 16.5-ton HTV, as well as geostationary satellites weighing up to 8 tons. The reliability of the H-IIA launch vehicle has been enhanced over a series of launches. The H-IIB launch vehicle makes full use of the H-IIA launch vehicle to improve launch capacity, while being developed at a lower cost and in a shorter period.
16.5トンに対応するために、新たにそういうシステム設計をやり直してですね、今の形の SRBAを4本つけた1段を大型化したですね、ロケットにすれば打ち上げ能力が達成できるということで、今の、ロケットの形態になったわけですけども。
The first stage body of the H-IIB launch vehicle was expanded to 5.2 meters in diameter from 4 meters, which enables it to carry 1.7 times more propellant. It is also equipped with 4 solid rocket boosters, or SRBAs, to improve its launch capacity. The greatest feature of the H-IIB launch vehicle is the clustering of two LE-7A rocket engines used in the H-2A launch vehicle.
クラスターって2台つけてですね、同時に燃やすっていうのですね、非常に信頼性が高くてですね、B もやっぱりその延長線上っていうか、兄弟ですから、非常に信頼性が高いというふうに私は思ってます。
The H-2B launch vehicle test flight, carrying the H-2 transfer vehicle, or the HTV demonstration flight, will be launched from Launch Pad 2 at the Yoshinobu Launch Complex in Tanegashima Space Center. Once launched, the H-2B launch vehicle test flight will jettison stages as it gains altitude.SRBA first pair jettison, second pair jettison, satellite fairing jettison, first stage separation.About 15 minutes after the launch, the HTV demonstration flight separates. After separating from the H2B launch vehicle, the HTV will stabilize itself.And initiate communications with the HTV Mission Control Room at Tsukuba Space Center. It will take the HTV demonstration flight about 1 week while conducting verification tests on the solo flight to reach the International Space Station ISS. Once the HTV is in close proximity to the ISS,It will slowly approach the ISS while measuring the distance to it. It will be controlled by the rendezvous sensor to retreat should it get too close and come to a stop at a relative position 10 meters below the ISS. When the HTV Mission Control Room confirms that the HTV is positioned 10 meters below the ISS,The International Space Station crew will operate the ISS robotic arm to grasp the HTV. It will then be berthed to the International Space Station module called Harmony. The HTV features an almost square.1.2 by 1.2 meter hatch like that of the space shuttle for loading and unloading large experiment racks.
Progress と ATV で共通しているのはですね、接続して荷物を出し入れするポートが直径80センチしかないんですね。となると人間がやっとこう通れる程度なので、当然そこを出し入れできる荷物しかダメだ。ところが HTV の場合はその一番上の弱粒のあれは 1.2 メートル四方あるんですね。だ非常に大きな荷物は出し入れできますし、実験装置もですね、大きなこのラックごと出し入れできますね。
Another major feature is the large opening of the unpressurized logistics carrier, which enables exposed pallets to be unloaded directly from the HTV with exposed experiment devices on them.The ISS robotic arm will be used to take the exposed pallet out of the HTV. The pallet will then be handed over to the robotic arm of the Japanese experiment module Kibo and installed on the Kibo external experiment platform. Once the exposed experiment devices are transferred to the external experiment platform, the exposed pallet is returned to the unpressurized logistics carrier. The HTV Demonstration Flight will be berthed with the International Space Station ISS for about 1 month, during which basic supplies such as food will be transferred to the International Space Station, along with other equipment for the mission such as the small fine arm of Kibo's robotic arm and the exposed experiment device called SMILES, which will measure atmospheric components in the ozone layer. Then the HTV will be loaded with waste, undock and separate from the ISS. After departing from the ISS, the HTV demonstration flight will re-enter the atmosphere where it will burn up. Once the launch of the H-2 transfer vehicle HTV successfully completes this technology demonstration, one launch of the HTV is scheduled every year using the H-2B launch vehicle. The HTV will dynamically support the activities of the International Space Station.
本当に感慨深くなるのは、あの打ち上げられた後、あの、HTV 分離という声をですね、聞いた時だと思いますね、多分ね。はい。
The HTV realizes efficient cargo transportation to the International Space Station ISS. The H2B launch vehicle is opening the door to the future of space transportation. The first HTV demonstration flight will finally be launched on the H2B launch vehicle test flight in September 2009.